Yellow spot and septoria nodorum blotch are major fungal foliar disease, diseases of wheat, which occur frequently together in Western Australia and are usually prevalent throughout the wheat belt, especially if conditions are favourable. The impact to the two diseases varies greatly from season to season and also between locations. Those farming practices which use susceptible varieties and wheat after wheat cropping and also stubble retention are the most affected. Another risk factor is the weather conditions. If wet weather conditions prevail for long periods, diseases cause more damage. Yellow spot produces typical eye spotting lesions on leaf surfaces, and these lesions are oval or diamond shaped or elongated, but they have necrotic brown centers and yellow halos. Nodorum, on the other hand, produces dark brown symptoms, which are sort of lens shaped and they run parallel to the leaf veins. So when the disease appears early in the season and there's high disease pressure, for example, if a susceptible variety is grown into last year's stubble and wet weather conditions are prevailing, you get high disease pressure. In that kind of a scenario, it's best to apply fungicides between tillering and stem elongation. It would be good to follow this up with another fungicide spray at flag leaf emergence, that is if the wet conditions are still prevailing. However, if you have a dry spring, any sprays after flag leaf emergence don't provide any benefits. So seasonal conditions are quite important. The best management options for the two diseases include, firstly, a 1 year break in wheat on wheat rotation because the diseases are stubble borne. Secondly, stubble management, and most importantly, the use of resistant varieties. Application of fungicides can be beneficial depending on whether the diseases have been diagnosed correctly and that the sprays are well timed. Fungicides which are registered in WA for yellow spot and nodorum blotch include products with active ingredients of propiconazole, tebuconazole, prothioconazole, and azoxystrobin. So those are the four active ingredients that are registered. And currently there's no issues with fungicide resistance developing for these diseases in WA, but it's still important to alternate the active ingredients just in case some other pathogens are present in the paddock. Research on yellow spot and nodorum blotch is underway through a national yield loss curves project, which is funded by GRDC. The background to this project is that although the NVT program provides resistance ratings for various NVT lines and varieties, not much has been done in terms of losses caused by these diseases. And it's important for growers to know how these ratings relate to yield loss.